You see, when we start the path of neiqigong, we might want to get involved at the beginning into it because we are attracted by these videos that I show where shifus do these big qi manifestations. And sometimes it's quite weird also because some people, even before starting the path, they claim and they feel the qi or whatever it is. Well, it might be true or not, I don't know. Most of the time it sounds like a quite silly things when you want to approach a system that teaches you how to do something if you claim that you already know that. But I want to spend some words about the qi expressions and qi sensations in the body. There is no one specific thing that we can point as the ultimate point of arrival, because it's a constant growing process and the sensations keep on changing. For instance, we see people talking about this Ying Qi, this Yang Qi, this Jing, Shen, Qi, different expressions that define in a certain way with words, so nothing to do with the reality itself, because words are just pointing, not the thing itself. The various kind of qi sensations that we might develop in the body. And there is something I want to say, because when we practice these kind of systems, especially if we do something that is a proven system in the sense that is really able to develop certain possibilities in ourselves, the process grow and develop itself little by little. So one might think it's qi one day, next day, well, after a few months possibly, we realize actually there is something more. Or it was just a temporary manifestation of that energy. Because working with the systems allow a transformation to take place in the body, in the vital energies, and in their currents. In the flow, in the way they move, in the directions they move. So that's why I encourage always a kind of skeptical approach and scientific approach towards the practice, because no fixing too much and having a fixed idea about this is it allows to have that correct distance to see the process where it's going naturally, not where you're leading that process with your mind or with your intellectual researches that you might be doing while you do this thing, this path of qi. It's normal that we might develop an involvement, an interest into finding out more, reading. But I truly encourage people to practice and to verify the sensations over a period of time, and then to report them to a teacher, in this case me, that can tell, yeah, that's correct, that's a good understanding that you are developing on your own about this level of reality that exists in life. So it's very good not to have a fixed idea from the very beginning of what it can be. And even when we start to have some experiences, not too much focusing only on them, because if we truly apply this system, we will see that there will be changes, substantial changes in the way that we perceive, in the way that we are able to manipulate it, in the possibilities also, very interesting possibilities that open up when we start to refine this experience in ourselves. Because it's not just a matter of meeting qi and, you know, lighting up some paper or breaking stones. That's not the goal. There are much bigger possibility that can be open. Those are external manifestations that can be seen. Of course, can represent a proof for many people that there is something more we don't know. Because at the end of the day, what we do in the path of neiqigong is exploring and expanding the possibilities of the human being towards a layer of reality that exists, that is not perceivable at the beginning, for ourselves, but although it exists, although it regulates other people's life, even people that do not practice these kind of things. So the goal, well, the way that it works is that we extend the possibility of working with life itself and understanding the processes of life in their different factors. Processes that maybe we are living passively sometimes, but in this way we can start to know them, we can empower them, we can make them stronger, and we can even manipulate and understand what it is, opening up possibilities for the human being that honestly I don't know where they end, because the path constantly shows you that there is more that can be developed. And probably certain things were reported as, let's say, miracles or other interesting stories that come from books or things from the past. They are not that impossible. It's just that we don't know the human beings, how it works, and the possibilities that we truly have. So, just to recap this thing, when we experience some sensations at the very beginning, which is normal, I invite my students and people in general, maybe you're watching this thing, just to be open-minded and to continue practicing without the goal of getting anywhere. Because only by having the right distance from things, we can actually have the right benefits, and we can maintain an objective form of approaching this matter without influencing with our opinion, intellectual understanding, or what other people say. At the end of the day, only one thing is important, that we practice, and as I say, Shifu sometimes, practice, and we see for ourselves what it is, and we build our own knowledge. We don't come about with some intellectual things. We investigate ourselves, this layer of reality, as we are investigating the world with our senses. New perceptions will open up, new understanding of reality, well, more, I would say not new, but more complete perceptions of reality that involve also an energetic field, and the intuition will open up. So we will be able to see reality in a bit broader way, with more elements that can allow us to become better human beings. And that's the ultimate goal of the practice. Mm-hmm.